Rolling. Back. Three. Set.
We applaud you at this moment when time and events have proven you right. The United States and Egypt continue to work together to broaden the peace that started with that first step 10 years ago. The recent explosion of violence in the West Bank and Gaza and reinforces the urgency of moving toward negotiations. Hard work, creativity, and the willingness to take practical, not merely rhetorical steps are needed. Mr. President, if peace is to be achieved, if another giant step is to be made in sights, I'm looking forward to discussing with you your ideas as well as our own thoughts on how to ensure that hope displaces despair and real progress is made toward peace. Both of our countries also look with distress on the seemingly endless conflict between elsewhere in the Middle East are reprehensible and reason for alarm. Both the United States and Egypt strongly support UN Security Council efforts to end the war, and we share a firm commitment to freedom of navigation in the region and these goals. I'm pleased to have this opportunity to discuss how we can work together to achieve it. The scope of our cooperation, of course, goes far beyond the formulation of foreign and diplomatic policy. Egypt and the United States have also made common cause in advance. President, all Americans are especially delighted that your visit will take you beyond Washington. I hope that in the limited time you have, you will capture a glimpse of America's heart and soul. You'll find it in cities and towns across the country, in businesses and universities, and in our churches. There you'll find freedom and a genuine good mood. Your visit, I know, will strengthen. Some may not realize that the U.S.-Egyptian collaboration on security issues goes back over 100 years. Shortly after the American Civil War, General Charles Pomeroy Stone and General William Wing Loring, together with some 50 other officers from the Union and Confederate armies, a symbol of our enduring relationship. Stone was asked to design and construct the base for a huge statue, designed and constructed by a Frenchman, presented to the United States by the school children of France. Stone went to work with his usual energy. He gave lectures on Egypt to help finance the project and enlisted two of his former colleagues from his days in Egypt to help with drafting the plans and erecting the
warm greetings and heart's wishes for success and fulfillment. They value the United States as a friend and a partner in the search for peace and progress. This friendship is a lasting one, for it is based on mutual respect and a profound conviction that all nations, regardless of origin and degree, share a common interest in the preservation of American friendship and served as a force of stability and progress. Today, it remains a source of hope and promise. We are determined to deepen this friendship and intensify our cooperation for our common good. President Reagan has made a great contribution to the process of strengthening these ties in the past few years. He has taken many steps for the purpose of enhancing world peace and security. We commend him on his recent achievement and congratulate the American people on the courageous steps that is certain to reduce, to maintain insecurity, to eliminate insecurity, and stop violence and suffering throughout the world. Sincere and concrete concerted efforts are urgently needed for solving regional conflicts. In this respect, the Middle East is a region that requires special attention and top priority. Are preoccupied this year with domestic matters and national events. But history does not stop. It is an absolute must that we continue to move forward to attain our objectives. This has taken courageous steps in the right direction. This active role must continue for our mutual benefit. The risks involved here cannot be compared with the damage that's certain to result from inaction and stagnation. Growth and development in most parts of our country. An equitable solution must be reached if we want to save the lives of millions who face the danger of starvation and fatal disease. The rights of our fellow Africans are being violated and their security is being endangered every day. The fight for human rights and the dignity of man, indivisible, and we must coming generations. I'm looking forward to a stimulating and fruitful discussion with President Reagan and his able associates, and we shall continue to objective exchange of views during the months ahead. We shall always be guided by the spirit of genuine friendship and sincerity, which has dominated our relations consistently. Together, we shall endeavor to serve the cause of peace and revive hope in the midst of despair and frustration. Together, we shall overcome. Thank you, Mr. President.
Okay. This way, please.
Excuse me, sir.
Wait, thanks, bro.
Sir?
I saw you.
Mr. President, what do you think of the Democrats' counterproposal on Contra A, their own plan?
No, I'm not going to take any questions. This is a photo opportunity.
President McGuire, are there any steps you would like the United States to take to stop the violence in the territories?
Let us discuss with the President when we finish all the photographs.
Lights, please. Thank you.
This way, please.